Class address.
Recruit band up. Please move.
Good evening, family, friends, distinguished guests. My name is Recruit Van Dyke, and on behalf of Police Recruit Class 214, I'm honored to have the privilege of delivering the class speech to the creators, influencers, and supporters of future protectors. Tonight we finalize 21 weeks of training, weight change, simulated stress for reality. You could be doing anything right now, but you chose to dedicate your time to honor the future of law enforcement. You are the reason we yearn to wear the badge and fully commit to a life of service in defiance of the immediate tense portrait. Greek philosopher Plato stated, "The beginning is the most important part of the work." On our first day of the academy, you can notice fearful faces, crooked tie bars, wrinkled trousers, unshined boots. We began the journey with 16 recruits, but only 11 remained. Ancient Greek philosopher Heraclitus stated, out of every 100 men, 10 shouldn't even be there. 80 are targets. 9 are the real fighters, but one. One is a true warrior, and he will bring the others home. Each one of these recruits are the end result of 100 men exposed to battle. The diversity in our class molded us into steel. Backgrounds ranging from a mama's boy relocated from Long Island to a goofy former professional athlete. We did our best to put our past behind us, yet apply the wisdom we gained through personal trials and tribulations endured thus far. During my time in the Marine Corps, a quote that helped me justify my decision to serve in a time of war was a quote that stated, "People sleep peaceably in their beds at night, only because rough men and women stand ready to do violence on their behalf. Someone has to do it." Each one of these recruits had a moment of clarity, and they said to themselves, "I'll do it." I want to take a moment to recognize my class individual. Recruit Bears, your persistence in the face of adversity is contagious. Recruit Fenton, your refusal to quit or be limited defines your character. Recruit Goodall, your drive and ambition, while the youngest in the class, is going to be a great investment for your department. Recruit High, your stud. Calm, cool, and collected, regardless of the task coming your way. Recruit some broad. Society needs more individuals like you with a passion for youth mentors. Recruit Cavender, your ability to make us laugh on our worst days is an undervalued asset to any team working in a stressful environment. Recruit Mad, your energetic, proactive work ethic and highly active role in the academy does not go unnoticed. Recruit Miller, your commanding, instinctive ability to lead others effectively is admirable. Recruit Daniels, your stoic leadership fills a much-needed void in our class of development. Recruit Clark, I couldn't come up with anything. Jokes aside, the future of law enforcement is in good hands. Your ability to ad-lib training scenarios and learn on the fly is going to propel your career. Ancient Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius stated, "Waste no time arguing about what a good man is, be one." PRC 214 was honored to train with me. I comb my hair once, you know, it's a big deal. When we part ways tonight, I want to continually hear your accomplishments in and out of the uniform. Reflect on our class model. We begin and end each day by belting it out, followed by a check of gigs from Coach Sapp, which continually reminds us that presentation is everything and the minute details matter. Live with honor, serve with pride. Early on in defensive tactics, Coach Davey reminded the class of a concept that hits home with me. He stated something along the lines of, "After you chase the bad guy, hop a couple fences and get into a fight for your life, until backup arrives in about 3 minutes if you're lucky. You get back up, fix your uniform, and control your breathing. Because the cameras will be pointed at you in your worst moments, and you cannot show signs of weakness. We are the first line of defense. No one else is coming to save the day. When the safety of those academy doors shut behind us, and we're nothing but a framed glass photo on the wall, it's the foundation we've managed to build here that guided us home to our families. This is our send-off. This is our war trip. Former Secretary of State Colin Powell stated, "Perpetual optimism is a force multiplier." PRC 215, CRC 101, I could only hope to provide you with an adequate representation of what to replicate. Our journey was much easier due to high-caliber mentors reminding us how quickly time passes and to aspire to leave legacy. As we pass the torch, be sure to maintain the flame. In closing, I know you're all eager to take photos with your loved ones. Distinguished guests, I know you're not getting paid overtime for this, so I'm going to keep this short and sweet. You are correct, there's not a patch on my left shoulder, gentlemen. I'm unemployed, I'm up for grabs. To our coaches and administration, other than the highly debatable Top Gun award, which will be awarded tonight, one thing is for certain. We, PRC 214, are forever thankful for your continued service to our community, and your efforts do not go unnoticed. To some of us, your mentors, to others, your father figures. But whether you intended to or not, your actions will echo in eternity.